This is a Samsung 12 inches Chromebook. It's an older version and I wanted to check something on the keypad because it wasn't clicked properly on one side and I did split it open. I'll tell you in a moment how to do this. But this is the battery and I believe it's the original one, and it seems like it goes from this side to this side, and there is actually two parts of the battery, two different parts. So you have this one, it's like this half of the battery which is sealed separately, and this one, you can see this one is bulging at this point. If there is gas in there, it's better not to touch it actually. And you can also see it from the sides if you want to have a look. It gives you an idea. This is flat, it's how it should be, and this is bulging right there. However, I don't recommend you get a Chinese replacement because those also are at risk of being defectuous like this and causing problems or maybe even explode. It's better to get the genuine one or replace the unit altogether. And by the way, it wasn't bulging on the back cover. It's just when I removed it and mentioned this again, it was working perfectly. The battery will keep a very good charge. It was charging properly. It will stay charged. But this half side, it's not in good condition. Let's show how to remove the parts. You need to remove the pads on the corner, and then this one is going to be the pad side, track pad. You have 1, 2, 3, 4 screws, 1, 2 on the side, and 1, 2, 3. These are tiny screws that require a tiny Chinese Phillips head. You really need to get one screw that fits very nicely, not just at the surface, but deep into the screwdriver fits deep into the screw, so you grab it nicely. And also, because the screw is going to be stuck and difficult to start turning, just use a pliers and grab your screwdriver like this and just give it a kick, put some a little bit pressure, give it a kick to break it loose, and then you undo it. And then go for the corners. Obviously, I'm going to turn off the unit. Try with both hands and just bend it a little bit, force a little bit like this. Yeah, pretty much like this. And then slide your fingernail. Try not to get anything metallic in there so you don't make a wrong contact. Slide your fingernail. It should pop. It has many, many, many clumps. On the right side, it's easier. On the left side, I had this port and I could not open it from this area here first. So what I did, I went like that. At the back, there is also a little bit difficult, don't force too much. And I finished at this corner going from this way. The battery has 6 screws and the holes are only those with the metal. Some of the tabs are empty. Again, be sure to turn it off. So keep the power button pressed to turn it off. When it's fully off, then you can just maybe toss a little bit the battery, go careful, and pull carefully on the wires to remove the connectors. Just lift it maybe from one side like this, go gently, and that's the same way how we put it back in place. Just position it in there. You see it has small holes here for the tiny white tabs, so put it in there and press it from one side to the other side, and I believe it's going to even power on when you press it in. When you put back the cover, start with the rear and put it at an angle like this, otherwise you are going to break those tabs, and make sure you engage here this tiny slot properly inside, and then work around, press the tabs back in place towards the front of the unit. Some serial numbers for the battery. And the good thing is, even with the battery completely removed, so there's no battery in there, you can actually use the laptop. Just plug it in and it will power on. Let's see here. And it's powered up and it's working as it should without battery. So I'm going to remove the battery for myself because I just don't feel safe to have it bulging like this. You know, maybe it's still working, but maybe one day you are going to leave your home and the battery will start a fire. So it's really, really not worth risking that much. Last thing, do not keep your battery inside your home. It's not safe. It can fire up even if it's not plugged. You don't want to fire in your house. So bring it to some place for recycling or keeping outdoors. Don't put it into a bin or something like this. Do not throw it into the bin or to the trash, because it's going to get crushed inside the truck and may get fire. Dispose it safely, but do not store it inside your home. If you wonder about the touchpad, so on this side, it will just, I would press it, it will stay pressed. So what I did, I just, without forcing too much, I just pushed against it from the bottom. I did bend a little bit this plate, but again, don't force too much. And now it's clicking nicely again on both sides.